another example here, mosaicing. Now, we've talked about mosaicing before. We talked about panoramas, about aligning images and bringing them together. Well, instead of just a small, discrete set of images, suppose you actually have a video. So you're taking your camera and you're panning it around. What you might want to do is make a single image. Okay, and this comes from Michal Arani's work, of where you can see where all the frames are. Okay, you can sort of see this jagged line, each one being the edge of a frame, and you realize what happened is the camera was swept out this way, all right, and I'm able to make this single image, all right? And if I'm rotating my camera about its axis, I'm not actually doing any translating, the reconstruction can be perfect because I don't have any motion parallax. And if these things are planes, I have to align some points. How many points does it take? It's a homography question. That's right. Even Megan got 4 points for that. And in fact, if I am moving, but things are really on a plane, it's still 4 points. So there are other applications of motion analysis, you know, segmenting objects in space-time. Sometimes you can get the three-dimensional structure. If you know how the points are moving, you know which point is which, just like when you saw the person. You might want to learn the dynamics of how something's moved. Maybe you're doing physiology, and you're watching people moving, and you want to understand something about their gait and the dynamics of their gait. All right? Recognizing events and activities. You'd like to be able to say, what just happened in the video? So it's not just object recognition, it's action recognition. And finally, you might just want to process the video and understand the motion to improve the quality. So you might do motion stabilization, right? So that you've got this jerky camera and you'd like to get a nice smooth video out. There are simple ways of doing that and complicated ways. In fact, a colleague of mine here, Irfan Issa, and a former student of mine, Vera Quatra, and some others did some work on stabilizing video, especially when you have rolling shutters and cell phones. Anyway, these are all reasons for wanting to process motion.